Okay, so Streamlit announced on their blog that they are holding a hackathon. The app should use a large language model and be built with at least one of the following technologies. Additionally, it should address a real-world problem. So I thought, why not create a Streamlit app and submit my entry? Over the last weekend, I spent roughly 5 to 6 hours creating the app. In this video, I will give you a behind-the-scenes look at how I created it. The main goal here is to inspire you to create your own app, which you could add to your portfolio, or simply make for fun. And with that said, let's dive in. First, let me show you the app. As you know, there is so much educational content available on YouTube. But if you've ever wondered how well you understood the content of a recently watched video, you can use QuizTube. You just need to input the YouTube link to the video and your OpenAI API key. With that in place, QuizTube creates a quiz for you about that video, so you can test your knowledge. If you get everything correct, you will see a balloon animation. And if you have some incorrect answers, those will be listed down below. Okay, and in the sidebar, I have included some additional information about the app and my social links. To show you how it works, I have created the following Jupyter Notebook for you. Basically, I have broken down the app into 4 steps. The first step is to retrieve the YouTube video ID from the inputted link. I needed that video ID for the second step. So instead of writing a complex function to extract the video ID, I simply used the pytube module, which offers that functionality. Here are a bunch of differently formatted YouTube links, but when I use the extract method, I get only the video IDs. Now, I already knew that I wanted to use OpenAI to create the quiz. But as you know, that would mean you need first get the transcription of a given video and then feed that text to OpenAI. I considered downloading the video, converting it to audio, and then converting that audio to text. But then I stumbled upon another Python library, which essentially extracts the captions from the video. Of course, there's a limitation. The video should have captions available. But I didn't want to make the app too complicated, so I thought this was a quick and easy solution. For this to work, you just need the video ID, which we already extracted. With that, I can easily obtain the captions of the video. The format looks like this. We have the text, the starting time, and duration. However, I'm only interested in the text, so I concatenated the text, and this is what I've got back. So this is basically now the whole transcription. Okay, and with that in place, we can now feed that text to the large language model. For that, I used LangChain and specifically their prompt template. I had to tinker around with the template text a bit. Initially, I wanted to get back the quiz in a dictionary format, but that didn't work out as expected. I actually had better results when I stored the quiz in a list of lists as specified in the template. So I just run the chain with my text, and here's what I've got back. Now, this output looks like a list of lists, but it's actually just a simple string. But with a built-in Python module, you can transform this string into an actual list. So when I print the data again, you can see it's cleaned up and that the type is a list. Alright, and that's basically it. Once I had that working, I created the Streamlit app. On my main page, you will notice at the top that I am importing some helpers. These are the exact functions I showed you in the notebook, but with some additional error handling. So I have a file to create the quiz using LangChain and OpenAI. And then I have some utilities to transform the quiz string into a list, and another utility file for the YouTube steps, specifically getting the video ID and the transcript from a given YouTube link. Lastly, I also have a fun helper file for my toast messages. This is actually a pretty new feature of Streamlit. Let me show you how I use it. When I reload the page, you will see a small toast message pop up in the bottom corner, which disappears after a few seconds. I asked ChatGPT to generate 20 of those messages, which I load randomly, just to add a bit of flavor to the app. Okay, back in my main file, I first set some basic page configurations before loading the toast messages as I've just showed you. After that, I've got the whole code for the sidebar, which is mainly Markdown. Then comes the title of the page and some more Markdown text to explain the app's purpose, followed by the input fields to gather the YouTube video link and the OpenAI API key. With that information in hand, I can call the different helper functions I have created. And to be honest, ChatGPT wrote most of the part below for me. What I'm doing here is loading my quiz data into session state variables and then displaying the quiz to the user. Of course, I also need to keep track of the user's answers to calculate the results. But that's basically it. To make the app more user-friendly, I included a short tutorial. So in my app, I have an expander element. When I open it, there's a quick tutorial hosted on YouTube. I will admit, I was too lazy to do the voiceover for that tutorial myself. So I turned to 11labs, where you can generate free AI voiceovers. All in all, on this project, ChatGPT saved me quite a bit of work. I basically just had to figure out the steps to generate the quiz, read a bit of documentation for the different packages, and then pose my questions to ChatGPT to get the code. And I hope this video inspires you to create your own project. By the way, you can check out my source code if you would like to reuse it for your own app. You can find the link in the description below. And as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.